Okay, so I'm trying something totally new and out of my comfort zone, but I've been wanting to do it for quite a while. I'm going to try to do what looks kind of like a little riverbed of resin, kind of in the ocean pour family, but with pebbles and sand. Just kind of my own little concoction of things. And today I'm using Famowood Glazecoat resin, craft resin. And I'm going to mix up maybe about 12 to 16 ounces. And it's a two-part, A to part B, exact equal amounts. You mix it for the same period of time, about 5 or 6 minutes, then you switch it to another cup, mix it again for another 5 or 6 minutes. It's one of the resins that you have to mix the longest that I know of. It becomes a little bit tiring, but I do like the resin itself. And I'm going to be wearing a respirator, so I'm not going to talk during the mixing and the making of the video. And maybe once it's cured a bit and I'll have my respirator off, I might be able to talk about it. But this is a 12 by 12 wooden art panel. And so I've taped off the edges with this vent tape that's kind of like aluminum, but it's really super sticky. It stuck to the puppy pad on the bottom. I had to throw that away and start with a fresh one. I've got some little pebbles. I've got a mixture of sand that has shimmer in it. It's part kind of copper and part kind of a corn maize color. So I wanted it more of a coppery colored sand. It's called light brown sand, but it's not like, here's a thing of more like realistic looking sand, and this is going to be a little bit warmer in tones. And I'm going to do a little bit of water that's going to have some blue tones. What I put on the board is I brushed on a unicorn spit, and they have a line that they're testing. It's beta testing right now, and it's called Artistic Vivations. It's got a lot of shimmer to it. I used Atlantis Metallic Turquoise, Poseidon Patina Bronze, which is a green color in this area. And then in this part, I used Hephaestus Ancient Bronze and Zeus 24 karat gold with a little bit of this pearly white mixed in just to soften it. And I'm going to probably put some of that color into the cups of resin and smaller cups when I get going. And so I've got some 3 and 5 ounce cups I can, you know, break out my resin into. I am going to put resin in my sand to help it stick to the bottom. I just don't know how this is going to work, so I'm experimenting at this point. And yeah, I'm excited about it. And I have a little bit of white opaque pigment for epoxy. I think it's supposed to be really good for helping with lacing. I do want some lacing in the water of the wave parts, but there's not going to be a lot of it. So we'll just see how that goes. So the rest of the video is going to be just kind of filmed, and I'll fast forward it through the mixing. Slow it down a little bit further along when I get to the part where I'm getting to create it. So I'm going to put my respirator on so I can work safely. I've got open windows, ventilation, and as you can tell, it's very hard to talk through the respirator. Thus, I'm not using the microphone. Okay? Okay, so you see that I covered a round that I had done. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with it. I'm gonna embellish it, but I wanted to put a coat of resin because it had some craters in it. And this, the lacing didn't happen with the kind of white pigment that I have. So I'll have to find some other white that will do some pretty lacing for me. And but otherwise, it's kind of cool, and for my first time ever, I'm pretty pleased with it overall. I do have some little tiny rocks I may just fill in. I like it to where it looks like the water has washed over the rocks. So I'm gonna cover these and get out of the room so that I'm not exposed to this. So I'll be back in about 12 hours or so to let you see the results. I am back. And the resin has had 24 hours to cure, about, I don't know, 10 hours in or so. I took the tape off the edges, and that worked really pretty well as far as making sure that there was no seepage of the resin for the most part. It's funny, when I hold this, it looks like I'm holding a pie. It was an acrylic pour and beautiful metallic colors, but it cratered pretty significantly, as you can see. But I thought it was still so beautiful in the shimmer. And this is actually my favorite part right there. So I decided I would resin it and do some kind of artwork on top, and then put another coat of resin and seal that artwork in between. I haven't done that before. Plus, one of my hairs is in here. It's sealed in there pretty good, so it's going to get sealed in between the artwork. But that's how that turned out. And I learned something after I did this resin piece with the taping of the with the heating tape. You can also use a tape called tuck tape, T-U-C-K, tuck tape, and you can use that as well as this. So this, you know, I taped around the edges. It's super sticky. But I put the sticky side against the wood base and against my other piece, which I'll show you here in a second. But here's the way I should have done it. So I should have peeled the tape apart. So I've gone ahead and taken off the backing. And then what you do is you fold. She made it look so easy, the video that I saw, but you fold it in about like 2/3, and then you take the part that's sticky and you tape it to your piece, and this part here that's not sticky is the dam that your resin is against. So when you pull that tape away, you don't have a sticky surface, and I have a sticky surface because my tape was stuck against the resin. So I kind of messed up on that, and I'll have to paint the edges to not have it be sticky. But so I should have taped the edge of the wood, and then let me show you too what it would look like, so that when you tape the edge, your inside piece of this tape is not sticky, and therefore your resin will not have a sticky surface when you peel the tape off. So that was something I learned. I'll know now on the next time. The resin kind of went up on a curved edge. So here's my other piece. I wanted to show you up close. It's got some sticky sides too, and I actually took a Dremel tool to the sides to take down the edge a little bit, but I must still put another layer of resin on it, I decided. But here is my first attempt There is some shimmer in the water, but not a lot. I didn't really want it real shimmery, but I did want some. And I thought I would get more lacing with the white pigment, so that was not the lacing that I expected to get with the water, but it still looks okay. And the rocks came out phenomenally on top of the sand. The sand was kind of hard to get it to stick down to the board, but it did stick. And there's some bubbles in the sand, but that's okay because, and you probably can't see it, but because typically you might would see some bubbles in sand where the water is over the sand, so I don't mind that at all either. So I had a few places where my tool accidentally made some marks on my resin with my Dremel tool. And I do have a little lip, as if you can see that lip. So I'm going to put another layer of resin to build up that layer on top. And I may put a few other, I want to maybe go a little bit lighter with the water this time, maybe a little bit of a lighter turquoise over this and do a little bit more white of the water. Maybe even put a little white over on this side as well. So that's my plan, is to put another layer of resin and hopefully build up this ridge to where it's not so noticeable. And then I used a wood panel board, an art board, and I'm planning on staining the wood sides kind of a brownish color to just make it feel natural. And because I did get a little bit of color from the resin that just came through in a couple of places, because that tape was super sticky, and once you put it there, you kind of couldn't move it around. So, you know, for my first experience, I feel like I did pretty good, and I think it's going to be a cool piece when it's totally finished. So I just see, you know, going bigger and better as time goes by, or smaller. I might do some smaller pieces. I've seen so many cool ideas on Instagram, and there's so many talented resin artists out there. It's a lot of work to work with resin, plus the chemicals, and I don't care if it does say that it's non-toxic. You should always wear goggles and a respirator and everything. I just believe in being extra cautious with your health. I'm not going to risk my health for art or for anything, even if it is my passion. So I'm going to build this one up with art and another layer of resin. And this one will also get just a little bit more. But overall, I'm tickled pink with the outcome of it. So it may be in the same video, or that might be a second video. I may go ahead and post this video and then put the second video out of finishing off the piece. So that way you can have a special treat. So I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe if you've not already. I can always use your support just by being a subscriber. And if you don't mind letting the ads run for their 20 seconds or whatever, that just gives a little tiny bit of revenue to me, which I don't make a lot of money on YouTube, but every bit helps to go towards my supplies. And I greatly appreciate it. And please share with your friends if you think somebody would be interested in watching my channel and learning some art tricks and tips and ideas and inspiration. Please share my channel with somebody you know. So anyway, there's that. And I will post a video, I guess, on another time finishing up this piece and this piece at the same time. So I'll see you on the next video. Thank you for your support. Bye-bye.